Apex Legends coming to mobile, NFS will have a remaster, and a Suicide Squad game is under development. These are some of the big news that we will be covering right here today, so smash that like button right now and help support Gamer Connect as we build this awesome GC army. And let's just jump right into top gaming news. CD Projekt Red released Nightwire City Episode 1, which means there will be more episodes coming in the future, and this episode showed us some really interesting things. We saw Brain Dance, which can record a person's experience and you can play them back to relive that moment or to find some really interesting clues. This feature has been used in previous games as well, and this right here is more fitting because it is a game of the future. But apart from that, various other content creators got a chance to play Cyberpunk 2077 and they have released some really cool information that you might want to know. The game featured three life paths, a street kid, a corporate agent, and a wandering nomad. And what you choose matters because then you can build up a story for your character, that is V. If you're a corporate, Jackie, who will become your ally eventually, is already a trusted friend and partner. For street kid, he becomes an ally after a botched deal, and for nomad, you guys team up after a messy fight in the Badlands. This will provide a good backstory to the character, and I actually really like it. Now, cars in this game, they look absolutely stunning because they're futuristic and they have amazing designs. Not only that, you can drive in first person mode as well as a third person mode. And when you're in first person mode, you can see all the details inside the car. It is magnificent how they made the details of each car in this game, which means CD Projekt Red, they know how to put details in their games. Now, not only that, you can also call your car to come towards your position, similar to what you did with Roach in Witcher 3. You just whistled for him and he would come by. Now, this is also similar to Batman, where you can call the Batmobile in Arkham Knight by pressing one button and then you immediately just sit inside the Batmobile. That was an amazing transition, and I think this right here will also be in the game. Now, of course, comes the customization of every character, which a lot of people are very, very interested in. I mean, you get the normal skin, hair type, muscle type, all of that, but you also get gentinels, and you have a lot of variety in those gentinels. And of course, you get to see everything that you have already seen in GTA games, such as nightclubs, noodle shops, gyms, and other type of clubs as well. You know what I'm talking about. And as I said, the details in this game are absolutely beautiful. The day and night cycle looks amazing, and even at night, the game looks wow beautiful because you have neon lights, you got so much lights in the city, it looks absolutely fantastic. Actually, these type of videos are making me more excited for Cyberpunk 2077. What about you guys? We got more episodes coming from Cyberpunk themselves, so we gotta wait and watch what else they will show in the future. Mobile gaming has been growing a lot, especially in India, with so many people, including my friends, play PUBG Mobile. And PUBG Mobile right now is the biggest game in India that a lot of people are playing right now. I see it all the time when I go outside. People are playing PUBGs in their mobiles. Whatever mobile they get, they're gonna play PUBG Mobile. We also have more mobile games such as Mobile Legends, which looks a lot like League of Legends. There is also Dead by Daylight on mobile, and now it seems like Apex Legends might be coming to mobile as well. During an investor call, the CEO of EA told that the company is looking to release the game in mobile as well. They already know the amount of reach mobile gaming is getting and they want to dive into it as well. Earlier this year, EA said that Respawn Entertainment is working on a Switch port for the game, so they can definitely go for an Android and iOS game as well. Now, I'm not a fan of mobile games because I don't see mobile as a gaming device. I would rather invest in a PC, maybe the PC games or PlayStation games, than investing in a mobile. But there are a lot of people who are playing in mobile, and there are also mobiles specifically built for gaming, such as Asus ROG phones, which have been improved ever since they first launched, and they are now adding liquid cooling to make sure that the mobile doesn't heat. Now, without a doubt, mobile gaming is booming right now, especially in India with PUBG Mobile, and it seems like many more companies want to dive into it so that they can get more gamers in and of course more sales. What do you think about Apex Legends coming to mobile? In my opinion, I would never try Apex Legends in mobile because it's a fast-paced game, and also I don't play mobile games that much, and the only games I do play are puzzle games or maybe some visual novel games like that. Well, we saw during the EA play that there is a new NFS game being developed by Criterion, and it seems like there are rumors surfacing that NFS will have a remaster for Hot Pursuit. According to VentureBeat, a remaster for Hot Pursuit is coming from Criterion, and not only that, there are 7 more games coming to Nintendo Switch, and one of them is this remaster, Hot Pursuit. The article suggests that Plants vs. Zombies Battlefield Neighborville, FIFA 21, Apex Legends and Burnout Paradise Remaster will be coming to Switch. Again, these are rumors, so you can take this with a pinch of salt as they are not completely true. Apparently, the report says that the remaster of Hot Pursuit will be coming to all platforms. But is that true? Well, we have to wait. Now, earlier this year, EA has given all the rights of NFS games to Criterion Games, who have made Burnout Paradise, which is one of the biggest games, and they have also made two other NFS games as well. One of them is NFS Hot Pursuit 2010, which in my opinion is a great game, and the other one is NFS Most Wanted 2012, which was their version of mixing Burnout Paradise and NFS. Ghost Games, who were the previous leaders of NFS and have made past 4 NFS games, including NFS Heat, which in my opinion is much better NFS games than the past 4 games they have created. Again, that's my opinion of it. What do you guys think? Now, there has been issues with Criterion in the past. Some of its employees moved to Ghost Games and the founders of Criterion also left the company. But it looks like EA has the confidence to let Criterion lead NFS. And so far, we have only seen a cinematic video of NFS, which absolutely looks stunning in terms of visual, but we actually don't know how the game will perform. Most importantly, whether that game is the rumored remaster of Hot Pursuit or is it a different, completely different game. Let's get real. NFS has been going on a downside. And only recently, NFS Heat is a much better NFS game, which a lot of people want to play right now and also have brought a lot of players back to NFS games. And to be honest, I just want a good NFS game. And I have hope for Criterion because they did make Hot Pursuit 2010, although they did also make Most Wanted 2012, which didn't give me any feeling of the original Most Wanted, but I still have hopes. But of course, what do you guys think? Let me know in the comments below. One thing I really want is a good Batman game. I mean, why not? Arkham Knight was such a good game. Even the previous Batman games are so well made. But I also want one thing that I have stated in the previous videos is that I want a day-night cycle of Batman where we get to see Bruce. But I don't think so it's possible. But one thing is getting rumored, and that is Batman getting a new game. Not only that, we got 2 more games from DC side. It was pointed out on Reddit that Batman Gotham Knights, Suicide Squad and Suicide Squad Kill the Justice League have a domain register for the website. Now, usually when a game is announced, they make a dedicated website for these games, and this right here shows that they are making these games. But then again, these are rumors, so you should take this by a pinch of salt and should not think that this is actually true. Batman Gotham Knights will be made by Warner Brothers and it might be covering Court of Owls based on screenshots that were uploaded a few days back on Twitter, and it seems like all the games that I just mentioned right now will be a part of DC Fandom event, which is happening on August, where a lot of things about DC TV shows, movies and even games will be announced and much more. They will also be featuring fan arts and cosplays, and I have registered my fan art in there, so I hope I get featured as well. Now, Batman Gotham Knight is made by Warner Brothers, but Suicide Squad will be made by Rocksteady, who has last made Arkham Knight, and I'm so excited to see a Suicide Squad game of all games. That one I did not expect. There were also rumors that Superman game is being made by Rocksteady Studios, but that rumor has gone cold. But you can play a Superman type game in Steam called Undefeated, which is a free to play game, and you should definitely check it out. So what are your opinions of Batman games? Have you guys played any of the Batman games? And you should definitely, if you haven't already, Steam sale is up right now and this is the best time to buy those Batman games if you haven't already. Next month we'll bring the Xbox event that was promised after the first Inside Xbox, which was a drastic event, and it looks like this new event will be broadcasted live. Now, Xbox has tweeted out in Twitter saying, "That's the plan. Hopefully you will join us for the live video event." Now, I am also confused because live event video can also mean a pre-recorded video showing up live. Some confusion right there. But nonetheless, Phil Spencer is very much positive for Xbox Series X and the games that they will be announcing for this event, because so far we got not much interesting games, and I hope that this new event can bring more new games and especially something more new to Assassin's Creed Valhalla. For example, giving us a true gameplay to Assassin's Creed Valhalla. Now, Phil definitely knows how Inside Xbox was a disaster because he himself said no grainy cameras will be used in this event, and he also states that he wants the show to have a good production and not cringy. My god, Phil Spencer is hitting hard on his own team. And I sincerely hope that Xbox event does do good, because they have to do something ever since PlayStation 5 reveal was hella amazing. Square Enix, who are also behind Avengers game, which till this point doesn't look quite interesting or exciting since I have no idea on the gameplay and the frames. the frames of that game, it looks like it's not even running at 30 FPS. They definitely have to do something about it to make sure that people enjoy the game. But it looks like Square Enix might be announcing new games in July and August. In stockholders' meeting for the company, a question about announcing new games in E3 was asked, to which Square Enix replied that they will announce new titles individually from July to August. Now, maybe this could be very much similar to what EA did with EA Play, or they might be announcing these games one by one. Square Enix has produced some really good games in the past, and I'm looking forward to one game, that is Project Athia, because it looks so good, and I hope they will talk more about this game in this event if an event happens. Well, we have to wait and see. Maybe Square Enix is building something new and is going to announce some new games which I would not see coming, and maybe a lot of people might not see coming, or they might talk about Project Athia and much more. We just have to wait. Well, next month we got Xbox event coming. We also have a Ubisoft event called Ubisoft Forward coming up, and then we also have something coming up from Square Enix, maybe announcement of new games and so much more. And this channel right here is where you will get to see all the news about those games. So definitely subscribe right now and enable the notification bell icon so that you don't miss a thing. And also help this video by hitting the like button and commenting down below what you think about this very episode and which games are you excited about the most. Make sure to follow us on all social media platforms so that you get to know everything about Gamer Connect and much more. My name is Gavin Madness, and I'll see you guys in the next videos. Bye bye.